It's a time in where people are defending Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the many ways they are coming up with, the different strategies, the different methods, things like boycotting and so on. But the idea is this, and there are some things that you will see going around, that the best way to defend the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to love him and to adhere to his sunnah and to adhere to his guidance. Well, that's not how you defend the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Why do I say so? Because these are essential matters for your iman. And these are something that you have to have if you believe in Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that you're supposed to love him, whether he's being insulted or not. That's something you already must have, and you already should be nurturing during your life, loving him and be adhering to his sunnah. When we speak about defending the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, promoting the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, teaching the world who Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is, the best way to do that is first and foremost to stand against this insult and mockery, to stand against it, to raise our voice against it, to make a big point against it, to be angry for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, because his messenger is being insulted and mocked. We need to be angry for his sake, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and our anger is for Allah Azza wa Jal's sake. And also we need to promote who he is. We need to teach the world who he is. Because I tell you, look, everyone that insults the messenger of Allah or mocks him, really, really, these people were ignorant about him. They were ignorant. They had no clue and no idea who he is. And they treated him just like any other random person. And so, how do you deal with that? How can we solve that problem? Opposite to ignorance, which is knowledge. So we're supposed to teach the entire world who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. We're supposed to spread his message to everyone. We're supposed to spread who he was as a human being. I mean, the disbelievers, those that were educated among them, saw that. Like, you know, the book of the 100 most influential people in the world, in history, Michael Hart's book. And that the first one he mentioned in his book was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a kafir that testified, number one influential man in the world is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Why did he come to this conclusion? Because of education. He was educated. He looked into the history of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He realized what a man he was. And he himself, he explains why he chose him. That Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a leader in every aspect of life. In every aspect of life. You know, as a father, he was a role model and an example. As a husband, he was a role model as an example. And Michael Hart, he did discuss in his book why he didn't choose Jesus to be the first one. He said because Jesus wasn't a father and he wasn't a husband. So he goes, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a father, was a husband, and he was a role model in these aspects in life. And he was a role model in terms of leading a community. On the battlefield, he was a role model in every aspect of life. He was a role model sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, I had no choice but to choose him. But I'm telling you that how did a kafir like Michael Hart reach this conclusion except through knowledge? So this is why we must educate the people in terms of who Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is. This is the best kind of defense you're going to have for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And of course, other matters, other things, if they're beneficial, we take them on board, such as economical boycott, boycotting certain products, if that's going to teach them a lesson, if that's going to teach them that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a red line not to cross, if that's going to teach them that mocking Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is never justified under the notion of freedom of speech, of freedom of speech or free speech, then we do that. And it, bi-ithnillah, alhamdulillah, it's proven to be beneficial. So we continue in that, bi-ithnillah ta'ala.